Praise God, here we are again. Jesse and I, praise God, amen. I want to speak a little bit about encouragement, amen. And as you listen, open up your heart. This is very important, amen. Matthew 11, 28 to 29, amen. It says, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am," what? "Meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls." Amen. We're always looking for rest, aren't we? I know one thing, when I go through a lot of changes, the first thing I do is begin to pray, because in prayer I find rest, amen? And I know that when I'm going through hardships, amen, I'm not alone because God is with me, amen? Then Jesus said, "Come to me, not run away or carry it all alone. All of you who are weary, tired, exhausted, lack of sleep, and carry heavy burdens, hardship, anxiety, grief, overloaded, and I will give you rest for your souls. For my yoke is" what? "Being prayed up, it's easy to bear, and my burden I give is light." Amen? That's tremendous. And then he says in Hebrews 4:16, "Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." Amen? That's heavy, you know. You know, the grace of God is tremendous. Amen? You can't earn it. You can't buy it. It's there. You know, it's unmerited. Amen? It's a free gift of God. Praise the Lord. Amen? But that mercy that God has, that he gave us, keeps us from going to hell. Amen? It opens the door for us to be receptive to the word of God. Amen? Also in Jude 1:20 it says, "But beloved, build yourselves up on the foundation of your holy faith. Continually progress." Amen? "Rise like an edifies large buildings. Stand tall, higher and higher. Pray in the Holy Spirit." Amen. So he's saying, you know, if you want to overcome your problems, start praying. Talk to the Lord. Amen. And the Lord of all storms will come in, praise the Lord, and help you, praise God. Amen. So many times, amen, because everything is progressive. Amen. There's times when you're going to go through things, you think they're not going to stop. They are going to stop sooner or later when you learn to be strong and your prayer reaches the throne room of God. Amen. It takes a lot of faith on this. You know? What about James chapter 1, 2 to 4? "My brothers and sisters, you will have many kinds of troubles, but this gives you a reason to be very happy." Amen. "You know that when your faith is tested, you learn to be patient in suffering. If you let that patience work in you, the end result will be good. You will mature and complete. You will be all that God wants you to be." You see, faith makes you smart. Faith makes you strong. Faith opens up your mind to receive what God is going to give you to overcome the problems that come against you. Faith is wonderful if you use it. If you don't use it, then it doesn't do anything for you. I hear people say, "Brother Matos, I got faith, and my faith is strong, and this and that." But when the trial comes, they don't know what to do because their faith has been broken by the problems. Amen. Instead of coming to the problem worker, who is Christ Jesus our Lord, amen, and build our faith in him, because he is the author and the finisher of our faith, then you're going to obtain the victory of whatever comes against you, praise God. Hallelujah. Romans 8:28, "And we know all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose." Amen. According to his purpose. Amen. For all those that have consecrated their lives to him, praise the Lord, without reservation, praise the Lord. Amen. It works. Let me tell you, it works. Praise the Lord. Amen. Not only that, but according to his purpose means, praise the Lord, that he is in control of your life. And he's going to work out your situation for you, because you cannot do it on your own. Amen. Also, praise God, hallelujah. In Hebrews 10:35-36 says, "So do not throw away this confidence. Trust in the Lord. Remember the great reward it brings to you. Patience, endurance is what you need now, praise the Lord, so that you will continue to do God's will. Then you will receive all that He has promised. You know what I mean? There's a great reward awaiting for each and every one of us. Amen. But there has to be patience. There has to be endurance, praise the Lord. Amen. You can't be a loser. You got to be a winner, praise the Lord. Amen. To receive all that God has promised us. Amen. And then Hebrews 11:6 says, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For you who comes to God, must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. God delays are not denials. Amen. God delays are not denials. Amen. Sometimes God takes a little while to see if you're going to grow. Praise the Lord. And as you begin to grow, the blessings begin to accumulate more and more. Amen. So I say this today, keep your faith open unto the Lord and open your heart that He might fill you with His blessings. Amen. God bless you.